Hello everyone, today we are going to talk about the worst dinner ideas. Don't worry, I'm not just going to blame food or blame you today. I'm going to tell you what is not right and how to make it right. I'm Dr. Ahmet Ergin, I'm an endocrinologist and a diabetes education expert. Today we are talking about the worst dinner ideas. Let's get started. So guys, literally, like when you come home, like you had a hard, long day and you would just want to sit down and settle and have a nice, hearty meal. But sometimes you don't really have enough time to kind of cook that healthy meal that we keep talking about. And unfortunately, unhealthy food is readily available everywhere. The fast food restaurants are everywhere, every corner pretty much in the United States at least. We have tons of unhealthy food, right? So what are the worst foods? Of course, the fast food is the worst one. Like that, we can start with hamburgers and fries, and that's super common and convenient, but that's something you definitely have to avoid. There's really no healthy hamburger, to be honest with you, because especially, I mean, if you're making it at home, that's not a big deal. If you're making it at home, and I'll explain to you in a second, but if you're buying from outside, they're all processed, right? So those processed meats, unfortunately, even if it doesn't increase your blood sugar as much, you know, you may think that, oh, my blood sugar is not going up, but you're still introducing a lot of toxic chemicals, preservatives, all this nasty stuff, excessive salt, that drives your blood pressure up, gives you edema, swelling, inflammation in your body. So it's not just about the blood sugar. When you make a choice, you need to make a healthy choice to help your overall health. Okay, so if you're eating at home, having meat patties like hamburgers at home is not actually that bad. If you can use a lean ground beef, for example, you can put all sorts of spices and you're making fresh, you know, preferably not even frozen. You can just buy it from the store and make it the same day. And you can put as much olive oil as you want, because most of the time when you cook those things, especially if you grill them, you know, you want some, you know, some fat in it to make it taste good. Of course, you don't want to use high heat with the olive oil, but you can definitely add olive oil. You can actually mix olive oil with some other spices like oregano, you know, pepper, some other things that you like. Rosemary, for example, would be great, especially for the meat. You can make a little sauce and put on top of your meat patty and make it a healthy fat instead of buying, you know, the most unhealthy part of the ground beef. So, and then the fries, of course, is a no-no. I know it is also easy to get, but you can definitely make roasted vegetables. You can make them crunchy. There's a lot of nice crunchy vegetables out there. Now, the vegetables, you can buy them frozen, right? So you can, as long as they're not processed, as long as just frozen vegetables are okay. You can just already fresh cut, you know, you just need to saute them or, you know, just roast them. And it's not really that hard. It's going to take you maybe 15-20 minutes, but that can replace your fries very well. Now, another thing that's commonly found in American diet, unfortunately, is hot dogs. There are very rare people who really don't like hot dogs, and that's because they're raised with it. You know, when you're raised with a food, no matter how bad it is, you just like it. So with the hot dogs, the problem with it, you know, there's really, again, no healthy hot dog. You're not gonna end up buying this with preservatives in it, and they're gonna put it in a bun, and that bun is just gonna be just simple carb, right? So the bread, if you're choosing your bread wisely, that may help you with your blood sugar. But again, just having a hot dog itself, even if you put in a lettuce, which is not going to taste good, is going to be full of xenobiotics and full of preservatives. So you need to still stay away from that. And to be honest with you, I don't have a good alternative for you for that type of food. So that's totally out. Now, pasta is very tasty and convenient, and I know a lot of people love it. Doesn't matter if you have diabetes or not, pasta is something that people are always having a hard time to quit. Now, definitely, I mean, even if you use a whole wheat or whatever, pasta will spike your blood sugar. What you can do, you can adapt to pastas that are made from zucchini, pastas made from like shiitake, pastas made from konjac. It's a little different taste, but it's not too difficult to adapt. And if you can achieve that, you can still get that satisfaction, that texture that you're looking for, or that vessel that you are looking to put your meat or whatever you're using the pasta for. It can still satisfy you and prevent the blood sugar spikes. But just having regular pasta in your diet, even if a couple times a week, is definitely not a good idea at all. Now, another common thing that I frequently hear from my patients is steak and potato. Actually, some of my patients will say that, "Doc, this is the only thing I eat. Pretty much 5 out of 7 days, I will eat steak and potato. And don't even talk to me about vegetables." This is what they say. I mean, it's amazing how people can be so stuck in their ways. But to be honest with you, I mean, steak, fine. Maybe if you're eating twice a week, I wouldn't hold you back too much. I mean, the red meat is not necessarily good for you if you're consuming too much. But just having potatoes with it, like mashed potatoes or fries with it, is just not going to help you at all for your diabetes. Now, what can you do? Well, you can use parsnip, right? So parsnip is something that not a lot of people know about. And parsnip, you can basically mash it and it's gonna taste almost like potato and it looks like a potato. And you can spice it up a little bit. You can put some, spices or some parsley, whatever you wanna put in there, and it's gonna look really great and you're gonna get used to it. So it's not like the potato is the only thing you have to have with the steak. Now, if you can again use roasted vegetables or the healthy things like some broccoli rice or shiitake rice, you can still eat your steak. I'm not prohibiting you from eating steak, but having potato right next to it is probably not going to help you with your diabetes. So basically, these are the most common food items or the dishes that in America we consume, unfortunately. I hope you guys learned something today, and if you did, please give a thumbs up, share, like this video, and if you have not subscribed yet, please do so. We'll see you in the next video. Remember, 3 videos a week. Hey guys, I hope you're enjoying this channel so far, and I hope you subscribed already. If you didn't, do it, and if you did, watch this video right there. I think that will help you too.